Hello children, hope you all are doing well. In our last class, we were studying the chapter magnetic effect of current. In that we studied about the magnetic field lines, their direction, properties. We also studied magnetic field due to a straight current carrying conductor, right hand thumb rule. Then we studied that if it is not straight conductor and if it is a circular coil, so how we will find the magnetic field lines, what will be the pattern. We studied solenoid also. So today's topic is about force on a current carrying conductor. Force on a current carrying conductor when it is placed in a magnetic field. Current carrying conductor when it is placed in a magnetic field. Okay, listen. Now, before this topic, I hope you remember that magnetic field lines always start from North Pole and end at the South. Inside the magnet, they go from South to North. That was the pattern. In right hand thumb rule, what we were saying that if the current is going in any direction, upward or downward, so right hand thumb rule was we will hold the conductor in such a way that thumb represent the direction of current and curling of the finger will represent the direction of magnetic field lines. Now what will happen if we will put a current carrying wire in an external magnetic field? Try to understand. In an external magnetic field, for example, I am putting here north, south. This is external magnetic field. What will be the direction? North to south. And if I will put a current carrying conductor in between this magnetic field, so what will happen? Now you all know that current carrying conductor itself have magnetic field. There are magnetic field lines. It means it have magnetic field. When we are putting current carrying conductor in external magnetic field, so because of that this magnetic field that is external and because of the magnetic field that is due to this current carrying conductor, interaction of both the magnetic fields, you know, comes in the form of force. See, try to understand here. One magnetic field that we are putting outside these magnets, external magnetic field, and when we will put any current carrying conductor, so that current carrying conductor itself have magnetic field. So magnetic field lines of this, magnetic field lines of this external one, they will interact with each other and here result will come with the force. There will be force on this current carrying conductor. So there is one experiment also, kicking wire experiment. It is given in our NCERT textbook also. You will read from that. And now see, what is that experiment? And after that, this result will come, that how the force is coming on that current carrying conductor. So what will be the result and how we will calculate? See that. Okay, so now see what will happen when we are putting any current carrying conductor in a magnetic field. So how force is arising and how we will find out the direction of force. So one thing that we will cover here, Fleming left hand rule to find out the direction of magnetic field, to find direction of force on current carrying conductor. So one thing is this. Now second thing is what bachaiye, force aa kahan se raha hai, from where this force is coming. Now listen, when I am putting any current carrying conductor, it means, for example, this is a straight current carrying conductor, current is going in this direction, and so magnetic field lines will be what? When the current is here, so magnetic field lines are anti-clockwise, okay? These are magnetic field lines. Now I am saying this current carrying conductor I am putting in a magnetic field. I am putting this in magnetic field means this side I am taking north pole, this side I am south. So magnetic field will be this direction, north to south. Okay. Now see clearly, when you will see this upper part, magnetic field is going this direction. Due to this current carrying conductor, magnetic field going in this direction. Niche ki taraf dekho, magnetic field is going in this direction due to the external one. And when due to this current carrying conductor, we will see it is going in the same direction. So see clearly, this side magnetic fields are in the same direction due to the current carrying conductor, due to the external magnet, both are in the same direction. So force will be more here. They will add up. Magnetic field strength will add up here. At this particular point, magnetic field due to outer one is this side, and due to this current carrying conductor this side. So this will cancel out. So there will be the force this side. Okay. Now if I am saying that it is parallel or anti-parallel to this, then what will happen? This side north pole, this side south pole. Magnetic field direction due to external is this. Now I am putting that current carrying conductor like this, parallel to the magnetic field, or I can say anti-parallel. In both the cases, if it will be parallel, firstly we will talk about the parallel. If it is parallel, again you will find out the magnetic field. These will be the direction. So what will be it? Clockwise. So you can give the direction. Okay, so it is going like this. SA is magnetic field lines are like this, circular concentric magnetic field lines. Now see this magnetic field, when you will observe, now see these are parallel ones, and board, on board it is looking like this. When you will take it outside the board, see clearly, current carrying conductor, and what will happen due to this current carrying conductor, magnetic field lines are going in this direction like this. Samajh rahe ho? And due to the outer one, it is going this. So there is no interaction of the magnetic field lines, there is no cancelling out, there is no adding up of the magnetic field lines. Here there is no interaction between the magnetic field lines due to external magnet and due to this current carrying conductor, if it is putting parallel or anti-parallel. So remember always, whenever current carrying conductor is parallel or anti-parallel inside the magnetic field, there will be no force acting on that. So now we will find out our kicking wire experiment. Uske help se we will find out the force. See, so what is the kicking wire experiment? Very simple. We took one current carrying conductor, we put that current carrying conductor inside external magnetic field, and we will observe that there is a force on the wire. Due to that, wire will displace from its position. So we need to find out the direction of that force. So how we will find out? With the help of Fleming left hand rule. Now what do you mean by Fleming left hand rule? Fleming left hand rule shows us that if we will stretch our left hand in such a way that thumb, index finger and the forefinger, middle finger, three are mutually perpendicular to each other in such a way that thumb represent force, first finger represent the magnetic field, and the middle finger represent the direction of current. So we can find out force, magnetic field, current. So we can find out the direction of force here. Now we will apply this rule here. For example, this is north, this is south, and a current carrying conductor I am putting inside this, between this. So what will be the force? Now tell me direction of current. It is going upward. This is two dimensional. Again I am repeating, imagine this, that you are taking it in your hand, a wire that is having current. Current is going upward. This side north pole, that side south pole. So how you will apply magnetic field is north to south. Current ka direction upar ki taraf hai. So what will be the force direction? What will be the force direction? Into the board, into the plane. If I say current is going downward, so what will happen? Index finger, jo hai, jo first finger hai, that will represent the magnetic field. Middle finger will represent the current, and thumb will represent the force. So if current is going downward, in the same case, north this side, south this side. So magnetic field is here, current is going downward, force is towards you. Okay, out of the board. Now with the same question, I will change this polarity, south this side and north this side. So what will happen? Magnetic field line direction will change. So now I am saying magnetic field is this direction. So much, you know, magnetic field is this side and current is going upward. You need to put it like this. See, magnetic field north to south, current is going upward, so force will be towards you. If I will change the direction of current, now what will happen? Magnetic field is that way and current is going downward, so force will be into the board. I hope you are getting how to find out the direction of force with the help of Fleming left hand rule. This rule we will apply when we know the direction of magnetic field, when we know the direction of current in that conductor. So we can easily find out that in which direction conductor will move with this rule. Now one more thing, jo maine abhi abhi bataya hai, if current carrying conductor is parallel or anti-parallel to the magnetic field, अगर मैग्नेटिक फील्ड और करंट कैरिंग कंडक्टर पैरेलल या एंटी पैरेलल है, इन दैट केस देर विल बी नो फोर्स ऑन दैट, देर विल बी जीरो फोर्स. ओके, सो नाउ लिसन दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट. विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट, आफ्टर टीकिंग वायर एक्सपेरिमेंट इज एक्चुअली द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक मोटर. इलेक्ट्रिक मोटर दैट वी विल स्टडी नाउ बेस्ड ऑन दिस प्रिंसिपल ओनली. ओके, सो सी हाउ वी विल स्टडी दैट. ओके, एंड दिस फोर्स ना, देर इज फॉर्मूला ऑल्सो, मैथमेटिकल फॉर्मूला that you will study in the highest standard, 12th standard. F is equal to I L B sine theta. This force ka formula na, this formula of force, see, this depend on the current. L is the length of conductor, I is current flowing, L is length of conductor. Derivation of this you will study. B, मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, थीटा एंगल बिटवीन करंट, और वी कैन से लेंथ ऑफ द कंडक्टर, करंट एंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, सॉरी करंट इज स्केलर क्वांटिटी, सो एंगल बिटवीन करंट एंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. नाउ व्हेन थीटा इज इक्वल टू जीरो, सो व्हाट विल हैपन, फोर्स विल बी जीरो. थीटा जीरो कब होगा, व्हेन आई एंड बी, फॉर एग्जांपल, करंट इज गोइंग इन दिस डायरेक्शन एंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज आल्सो गोइंग इन द सेम डायरेक्शन, सो बोथ आर पैरेलल. व्हेन बोथ आर पैरेलल, सो थीटा विल बी जीरो, एंड व्हेन थीटा इज इक्वल टू जीरो, साइन जीरो जीरो, सो फोर्स विल बी जीरो. इन दिस केस फोर्स विल बी जीरो. सेम वे करंट इज गोइंग इन दिस डायरेक्शन, मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज इन दिस डायरेक्शन, एंटी पैरेलल, थीटा कितना होगा, 180. नाउ व्हेन यू विल पुट 180 हियर, साइन 180 इज आल्सो इक्वल टू जीरो, सो फोर्स विल बी जीरो. रिमेंबर, व्हेन करंट एंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, कंडक्टर, करंट कैरिंग कंडक्टर एंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड आर पैरेलल और एंटी पैरेलल, द फोर्स विल बी ऑलवेज जीरो. इट विल बी मैक्सिमम व्हेन साइन थीटा, दिस वैल्यू विल बी मैक्सिमम व्हेन थीटा इज इक्वल टू 90 degree. सो इफ करंट कैरिंग कंडक्टर, फॉर एग्जाम्पल, दिस इज करंट कैरिंग कंडक्टर एंड दिस इज मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, इफ बोथ आर एट 90 degree, we can say current carrying conductor is at right angle to the magnetic field, in that case force will be maximum. Remember this thing. ठीक है, so now we will use this for the DC motor. We will study now DC motor. Okay, so now the topic is DC motor. Principle of DC motor is what? Force on any current carrying conductor when we place that in magnetic field. This is the principle on that DC motor works. You know, in most of the electrical appliances we see, like electrical fan, okay, mixer grinder, in that also there are certain kind of blades that revolve when electricity we switch on. Other than that, our washing machine also, there are also certain kind of blades that move. So all these appliances, fan is there, mixer juicer is there, and the washing machine is there, so they work, or the blades are moving in that because of one appliance, and that is known as the DC motor. This is responsible, because what is DC motor is doing, DC motor convert electricity into mechanical energy, convert electrical energy into mechanical energy. And the principle of DC motor is what, that whenever we put any current carrying conductor inside the magnetic field, it will experience a force. So that is the principle, and this DC motor we use in most of the electrical appliances where we need mechanical energy, where we need rotation of the blades. Okay, so we will see today that what is this construction, how it works and all. Okay, so now see DC motor construction or diagram, very simple. North pole, south pole, it means magnetic field is there, magnetic field is present there, direction is north to south, two magnets. Armature coil is present here, and this armature coil is connected to split rings. Why I am saying split rings, because it's not complete, like it is complete ring, and if we are breaking it from here, so what part will look like this. So this is exactly known as the split ring, because there is split ring between that. So for example, this is S1, this is S2. Now split ring is connected to the brushes, carbon brushes B1, B2, and these carbon brushes further connected with the battery, key, this is connected this side. Very simple diagram. So this is positive terminal, this is negative terminal. Current is flowing from here with the help of these carbon brushes, conducting brushes. It is going in this coil. Coil, for example, A, B, C and D. So direction of current, for example, for right now, it will be like this. So current is going from this side and current is coming from this side. S1, S2, split ring. These split rings are touched with the brushes, carbon brushes B1 and B2. Listen again. These wires are connected through these split rings and through this B1 carbon brushes and going into this battery. Circuit is complete. This side also. Split rings are movable. Split rings are not fixed here. They are movable. They are just touched with the carbon brush B1 and with the B2. Now, what will happen? Sabse pehle to, what is the principle? Force will act when we put current carrying conductor, inside a magnetic field conductor So see here, magnetic field is also there and current is also there. This is the direction of magnetic field. From here battery, you can see that current is flowing. Now this armature is made up by the soft iron core also. We can bound it with the soft iron core just to make it more conducting. Now see, when the current is going from this particular part AB, four part AB, tell me the direction of force. Current is going and you need to find out the force. You will not apply right hand thumb rule, but you will apply Fleming left hand rule. So according to the Fleming left hand rule, this will be the direction of current. This is the direction of magnetic field. So force is into the board. Use your own hand, left hand, to find out the direction of magnetic field. See for this diagram. When the current is in this part AB is going upward. So current is going upward. Magnetic field is this direction. Force will be into the board. This side. Force is into the board. Into the plane. Now for BC part, current is going this side, magnetic field is also parallel. So when I told in the last topic also, when the force will be what? When current and magnetic field is parallel or anti-parallel, zero. So at this part, force is zero. There is no force. Now for the CD part, see, when the current is going downward, magnetic field is this side, so force will be out of the plane. For this particular part, force is out of plane. And this part again, because it is parallel anti-parallel, so it will be zero. So now see children, when the current is flowing from here, this AB part, armature jo aise hai, A, B, C, D, there is a coil, armature coil, the shape is like this rectangle kind of shape. AB will go this side, start rotating, and CD will come out of the plane this side. After half rotation, now I told earlier that split rings are movable. So what will happen after half rotation, this S1 part will go to the B2 brush and this S2 part will go to the B1 brush. I hope you are getting this. See, when current starts flowing, magnetic field is here, force will start applying on that conductor, and when force application will be there, so due to the force on this part into the board, on this part out of the board, this armature start moving. How it forms a couple, because these forces. Now tell me one more thing, magnetic field is same for both, current is also equal. So because current also, we are supplying constant supply of the current, now we are not increasing decreasing the amount of current for different things. So constant supply of current we are giving, magnetic field is constant, so force will be what? Force will be same and opposite direction. This is into the board, this is out of the board, and they are acting on different line of action. They are not on the same line of action ki wo cancel ho jayega ki iske upar hi force into hai, iske upar hi force out of the board hai, so it will cancel out. No, different line of action hai, same line of action nahi hai. So because on this line force is into, on this line force is out, and that's why it will form a couple, and when couple will form, it start rotating. And after half rotation, this part, CD part, is connected here. This AB part will go this side. And what will be the direction now? Current C. Same diagram. The only thing with that will change is the here come S2, here come S1. After half rotation, this part. Now this A, B, and CD. CD will come this side, AB will come this side. Now, battery supply is there, B1 and B2 are constant. So, in this part now, current will go upside and in this part, current will go downside. So, what will happen? Again, when you will apply Fleming left hand rule, force on this part is into the board and force on this part will be out. So, again, same thing. It will move anti-clockwise. It will go into, it will go out and again it will go anti-clockwise. One rotation complete. Then again this part will go there, here. This part will go here. Again force anti-clockwise. So it will start rotating. Samajh rahe ho? It will start rotating. First part AB was here, then CD was here. So current was there, magnetic field was there. When you apply Fleming left hand rule, you will get the force on this part into the board, this part out of the board. Force are equal and opposite and they are not acting on the same line. So that's why it will form a couple and it will start rotating. After half rotation, the split rings are movable. You know, these split rings are movable and that's why S1 that was here now will go this side, S2 that was here will go this side. So direction of current will change and that's why this CD part will go now force in, act force into, and on this AB part force will act outward and again it will start rotation. Now again this will again comes S1 and this will again comes S2, here again AB, here again CD. So what will happen? It will start moving, motor start moving. So this is actually start working. Now listen, in the same part again I am making, when it was connected here like S1 was here and it was connected with S2 and here brush B1 was there, conducting brush, here it was connected with the B2 brush and then the battery was here. See, when it starts moving, there will be a time when, you know, because S1 and S2 are movable now. So see what I am saying, B1, so when it is moving and S2 is coming here, they are movable now. So when they will change their position, move, there will be a point when they are not in contact with any brush. See, like ये इस तरीके से मूव होगा इस तरफ जाने के लिए, यहाँ पे जो रिंग है दैट विल मूव दिस साइड इस तरफ आने के लिए, एंड देयर विल बी वन पॉइंट व्हेन आई एम सेइंग, सी दिस डायग्राम इज नॉट एक्चुअली क्लियर हियर, आई विल मेक इट, जस्ट वेट. दिस वाज अर्लियर डायग्राम, फर्स्टली आई एम मेकिंग अर्लियर वन. थ्रू दिस इट इज कनेक्टेड हियर B1 एंड सेम हियर it is connected to the B2. This is actually the diagram. Okay, see, S1, B1, S2. A, B, C, D, magnets were there, north, south. You got the direction of course, that I know. But now what I am saying, when it will start rotating AB into the board and this is out of the board, this just I am telling you, dot means into, cross means out of the board. So when it will start moving, this part will move into with that S1. This split ring will also move towards that side. S2 will come out of this and there will be a point when S1 and S2 are not connected with the brush B1 and B2. There will be a single, movement. There will be a time when S1 and S2 are not in contact for very little time, for very small amount of time, they will be not in contact with B1 and B2. So suddenly supply of current will not be there. Because armature mein current kahan se ja raha hai? Through these brushes, through these split rings, it is going here. So when split rings, this split ring will start moving here and this split ring will start coming here. So what will happen in this case, that S2 will be at this position. S2 move होने के बाद यहाँ आएगा और S1 move होने के बाद यहाँ आएगा. तो there will be time when S1 and S2 are not connected with the brush B1 and B2. So what will happen? Current का supply रुक जाएगा and जैसे ही current का supply रुकेगा, there will be no force. So क्या armature stop नहीं हो जाएगा? Because armature is moving when we are applying force on that. When force is there, when there will be no current. So because of no current, there will be no force. So how these armature is moving after that also. So here is inertia of rotation. You studied in the 9th standard also, inertia of rest, inertia of motion, that when a body is in motion, so it will try to move until and unless some external force is applied. So just for that moment of time, current will cut off from here, but due to inertia of rotation, it will start moving and it will just touch this B2 brush. S1 will touch B2 and S2 will touch B1. See this diagram. यहाँ पे थोड़ा सा ये गड़बड़ हो रहा है. See that you are not getting it clear. B1 and earlier it was, now S2 will come here and this will part become CD. This part will become AB and here S1 will come after motion and this is connected with B2. This diagram will come. But ये diagram बनने से just पहले एक moment ऐसा होता है when S1 and S2 are not connected with the brushes. So for that moment of time, current का supply off हो जाता है and there will be no force. But because of the rotation of inertia of rotation, coil is continue with the motion and that's why S1 touched here, S2 touched here and when it will touch here, so again current is going here, current is going here, so again you will get the force and it will start continue in motion. Okay, so here what is happening actually, we are giving electrical energy and finally electrical energy is converted because the blades are in motion. So what kind of energy is it? A kind of kinetic energy and that is known as the mechanical energy. So electric motor is doing what? Conversion of the electrical energy into mechanical energy. Electrical energy into mechanical energy. Mechanical energy. Split rings are also known as the commutator. Split rings are also known as the commutator. Why we are using split rings here? Just to change the direction of current in armature. Split ring also known as commutator. Commutator to change direction of current in armature. In armature. So when the question will come, how you will attempt DC motor question will come. First thing that you need to tell is what is the principle. DC motor is based on the principle that whenever we are putting any current carrying conductor inside the magnetic field, it will experience a force. After that you will write that what is the conversion electrical energy to mechanical energy. After that you will do the construction part. In that you need to draw that diagram. You need to tell there is armature that is wound with the soft iron core. There are strong magnets are putting their north and south pole. So magnetic field is there. There is battery. There are carbon brushes conducting so that current can flow. Split rings that are movable. So after that you need to complete right about the construction part. After construction part you will start with the working part. In working part you will tell that when current starts flowing, so in this particular part, AB part, current is in this direction, magnetic field is this direction, so force will apply into the board. On CD part, force will be out of the board. After half rotation, because split rings are movable, the direction of current will change AB to CD. So CD mein abhi force kahan lagega? Into the board, and AB part pe out of the board. So due to that, this armature will start moving and hence we can say DC motor is working. Electrical energy to mechanical energy. There are lots of appliances, electrical appliances in that we are using this. And why we are saying DC motor bacha? Direct current. Here that the battery we are connected na. So we are not changing the polarity. It is always same. We are not changing ki sometime it is negative, it is positive. No. And the amount of current is also constant and electrons are going in the same direction. Electrons, agar current is side hai, so electrons is in this direction. So DC current is what? DC current is the direct current. When there is no change in the direction of current and when it is constant supply of the current. So constant supply of the current, same direction. So that's why we are saying it is DC motor. So I hope you got this. Thank you. Just read out till this topic. Any doubt you can ask me. And in next class we will start with the new topic, that is electromagnetic induction. So read out doubt then ask me. Have a good day. Thank you so much.